Hey guys and gals, so this time I'm going to be turning this little letter opener. Now this was actually a project which I did before Christmas to give as a gift to my dad, and now Christmas is long gone, I can show you how to make it.
Right, so to make this letter opener I'm actually going to be using quite an interesting technique, off-center turning. But to start, I'm just going to mount up the stop which I'll be using for this turning, which is about 4 centimeters square. Then I can spin it up and begin turning. With the stock rounded off now, I could use a parting tool to mark out the length of the letter opener. In this case, I went for a length of about 20 centimeters. And now I've moved back to a roughing gouge so I can begin some initial shaping of the letter opener. And now that I have the rough shape which I want, I do some sanding. It's going to be a lot easier to do the sanding now than it will be later on, so bear that in mind. So with that done now, I can get on with the interesting part. And I begin by taking the turning off the lathe, and using a compass I mark a circle with a radius of about 1 centimeter. I do the same on both ends of the turning. Now the size of the circle is a rough indication of what the final width of the blade of this letter opener will be. And then I use a screw to mark 2 opposing points on the circle. Using the points where the circle intersects the center lines is a good way to do this. And then I do exactly the same on the other end, making sure I pick the 2 points which are opposite the points which I just marked. And then I can remount to the lathe using 2 corresponding off-center points. Next, you want to give it a few spins by hand, and that just ensures that it doesn't come in contact with the tool rest. And then you can spin it up, and I'm using a roughing gouge to shape the blade. There's not a huge amount of skill involved in this, you just want to introduce the tool nice and slowly to the wood and take nice light passes. And with the first side of the blade turned to shape, I follow up with some sanding. And then I remove it from the lathe and using the second set of off-center points, I remount it. And once again, using the roughing gouge, I do exactly the same for the second side of the blade of this letter opener. And now if I stop the lathe, you can see what doing these two off-center turnings has achieved. I've still got some further turning to do on this side of the blade, but by turning off-center, I've achieved an elliptical shaped blade. Following some sanding, I removed the turning from the lathe, and now I'm just cutting off the remaining stock off each end at the bandsaw. And I shape the tip of the blade to a point using a drum sanding attachment at the drill press. So to give this turning somewhat of a personal feel, I'm inscribing my dad's initials on the blade. To do this, I'm going to use a wood burning pen. I start by transferring on the letters which I printed off the computer. And then using that for reference, I can simply go over that with a wood burning pen. A final touch which I'm adding to the letter opener is to stain the handle black. I think that without doing something like this, the overall letter opener just looks a bit plain. And once that had dried, I used a few coats of lacquer to finish off the letter opener.
So here we go, there's the finished letter opener. So I hope you enjoyed the video today, and as always, I'll be posting some images at my website of the finished turning so that you can get a closer look, and I'll post a link in the description for that here. So I hope you also picked up a few little tips or just understanding of off-center spindle turning, and perhaps you'll have a go at that yourself. And once again, just before I leave, be sure to check out my last woodworking project up here, where I show you how to make a bandsaw box, and also my last video blog, where I show a bit more detail about my finishing process, which, as most of you know, I kind of skip over in most of my project videos. So check that out here. With that, I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.